So today we will be doing BOD and COD. Okay. So first of all, we'll start with BOD. BOD involves determination of BOD involves the measurement of dissolved oxygen used by microorganisms in biochemical oxidation of organic matter. Okay. And how you define BOD? The amount of the oxygen required for biological oxidation of organic matter under aerobic conditions at 20 degrees Celsius for period of 5 days. I have already put the BOD COD PPTs for you, so it is very easy for you to understand. Okay. So BOD is the amount of free oxygen required for biological oxidation of organic matter under aerobic conditions at 20 degrees Celsius for period of 5 days. What is aerobic conditions? Aerobic conditions means oxygen is available for the oxidation. Okay. Now, like aerobic decay compound, C having compound undergoes oxidation and becomes CO2, and anaerobic it becomes CH4. N becomes NH3 HNO3, and anaerobic it becomes RNH2. P becomes H3PO4 in aerobic, and anaerobic it becomes PH3, and S becomes H2SO4, and anaerobic it becomes H2S. So anaerobic decay is converting the product into the complex form, and the aerobic decay it converts the products in the easiest form. Okay. So have you understood BOD? It is the amount of free oxygen required for biological oxidation of organic matter under aerobic conditions at 20 degrees Celsius for period of 5 days. Okay, so how you have to and what is the unit for BOD? It is mg per liter. Now, before going into the solving the problems, we will see how BOD is determined. A known volume of sample of sewage is diluted with known volume of water. Dissolved oxygen content is predetermined. A known volume of sample of sewage is diluted with a known volume of water. Okay. And whose dissolved oxygen content is predetermined. Oxygen and microbial organisms are also provided if required. The control bottle is also prepared with only water and bacteria. Then the bottles are put into the standard incubator for 5 days at 20 degrees Celsius. Difference in oxygen level between the control bottle and the sample bottle with oxygen remaining is used to calculate the BOD in mg per liter. तो पहले क्या करते हैं, पहले सुवेज सैंपल का डिजोल्व ऑक्सीजन पहले प्रॉपरली डाइल्यूट करते हैं और उसका डिजोल्व ऑक्सीजन निकालते हैं, ठीक है, सुवेज सैंपल का. बाद में क्या करते हैं, उसमें ठीक से ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट डालते हैं और माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स डालते हैं, और एक कंट्रोल बॉटल यानी एक डिस्टिल वाटर बॉटल रखते हैं, उसमें भी ऑक्सीजन और माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स डालते हैं, और वो बॉटल एज वेल एज द स्वेज बॉटल अलोंग विद द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड ऑक्सीजन इज केप्ट इन अ इंक्यूबेटर फॉर 5 days एट 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस. ओके. बाद में उसका डिजोल्व ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट निकालते हैं. एंड प्रीवियसली हमने डिजोल्व ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट किसका निकाला था? सिंपली सिंपली अ सीवेज बॉटल का निकाला था बिफोर इंक्यूबेशन. ओके. तो आफ्टर इंक्यूबेशन एंड बिफोर इंक्यूबेशन का डिफरेंस निकालते हैं, और वो जो डिफरेंस इनटू डाइल्यूशन फैक्टर इज योर बीओडी. ओके. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड? यहाँ पे दिया है, देखो, बीओडी इज इक्वल टू डीओ, दैट इज डिजोल्व ऑक्सीजन before incubation minus dissolved oxygen after incubation into dilution factor. DO, dissolved oxygen present in effluent before incubation. DI, DOI is dissolved oxygen present in effluent after incubation. After incubation and into dilution factor. Okay, so I will give you the problems based on this. You have to solve it. It's very easy. You have to just calculate the dilution factor properly and then write. Problem likhke le lo.
Ma'am, can you repeat the formula once again?
Yeah. BOD is equal to EOB minus DOI into dilution factor. Okay. Whereas DOB is dissolved oxygen present in effluent before incubation, and DOI is dissolved oxygen present in effluent after incubation. And this two is subtracted, or difference between this two is found out, and into dilution factor will give you BOD. Got it, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
चलो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करते हैं इसके ऊपर. 50 ml ऑफ सैंपल कंटेन्स 50 ml ऑफ सैंपल कंटेन्स 840 ppm of dissolved oxygen, 840 ppm of dissolved oxygen. After 5 days, the dissolved oxygen value becomes 230 ppm. After 5 days, dissolved oxygen value becomes 230 ppm. After the sample has been diluted to 80 ml, after the sample has been diluted to 80 ml, calculate BOD of sample. Calculate BOD of sample. I'll repeat again. A 50 ml of sample contains 840 ppm of dissolved oxygen. After 5 days, dissolved oxygen value becomes 230 ppm after the sample has been diluted to 80 ml. Calculate BOD of the sample.
976.
Yes, 976. It's very easy. किसी को dilution factor समझ में नहीं आया तो याद रखो कि dilution factor is equal to ml of sample after dilution divided by ml of sample before dilution. Okay? Dilution factor, ये देखो यहाँ लिखा हुआ है. Dilution factor is equal to ml of sample after dilution divided by ml of sample before dilution. ये कहाँ से आया? आपको N1V1 formula मालूम है ना? Hello? यही है वो dilution factor. Okay? चलो और एक प्रॉब्लम ले लो. 50 ml ऑफ वाटर सैंपल कंटेन्स 50 ml ऑफ वाटर सैंपल कंटेन्स एवरीबडी गॉट इट आंसर?
यस मैम.
हेलो एवरीबडी गॉट इट?
यस मैम.
ओके ओके. नाउ अ 50 ml ऑफ सैंपल वाटर सैंपल कंटेन्स 50 ml ऑफ वाटर सैंपल कंटेन्स 500 ppm of dissolved oxygen, 500 ppm of a dissolved oxygen. The water sample is diluted to 100 ml. The water sample is diluted to 100 ml. After 5 days of incubation, 5 days of incubation, DO value of water sample, DO value of water sample reduces to 400 ppm. Reduces to 400 ppm. Calculate BOD of water sample. Calculate POD of water sample.
Ma'am, can you repeat once again?
Yeah. A 50 ml of water sample contains 500 ppm of dissolved oxygen. The water sample is diluted to 100 ml. After 5 days of incubation, DO value of water sample reduces to 400 ppm. Calculate BOD of water sample.
200 ppm.
50.
Correct. 50 कैसे आ गया?
200,
right? 200. 200. Yeah. 200. Dilution factor is what? 2. Dilution factor is what? 2. Got it? और एक चाहिए सम? और एक ले लो. 100 ml of water sample contains 100 ml of water sample contains 600 ppm of dissolved oxygen, 600 ppm of dissolved oxygen. The water sample is diluted to 200 ml. The water sample is diluted to 200 ml. After five days of incubation, the DO value of water sample, a DO value of water sample uses 300 ppm, reduces to 300 ppm, calculate BOD of water sample. Calculate BOD of water sample. Six hundred ppm, correct. 600 ppm. We'll go to the COD now. Yes? BOD, have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
It's very easy. Okay, COD is little difficult. You have to understand very, very properly. Okay? First, just check what has to be done. Experiment, I will tell you. First of all, you have to take an excess of your sewer sample. You have to take, you have to add an excess of K2Cr2O7 to it, okay? And then you have to add Ag2SO4, because Ag2SO4 will oxidizes all aliphatic compounds as well as a straight chain aliphatic compound as well as pyridine. Okay, straight chain aliphatic compounds, aromatic compounds, and the pyridine. So we have to add what? Ag2SO4, and as a catalyst, and then reflux whole thing, K2Cr2O7 plus dilute SO4 is added, okay? And reflux whole thing for 1.5 hours, and reflux whole thing into 1.5 hours. What will happen in this? You just tell me. Any idea? Sample is taken, and excess amount of K2Cr2O7 plus dilute H2SO4 is added, plus Ag2SO4 catalyst is added, and whole is reflux for 1.5 hours. What will happen? What is K2Cr2O7? What is K2Cr2O7?
Oxidizing agent.
Exactly, oxidizing agent. So it will oxidize the organic matter and the inert organic matter in the sewage sample. It will oxidize organic matter and inert organic matter in the sewage sample. So will the K2Cr2O7 will be consumed? Yes. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. So it will be corresponding to the amount of oxidizable matter.
Yes, some amount of this oxidizing matter, whatever the inert organic matter and the organic matter is there, it consumes K2Cr2O7. So what will happen? Whatever initially added excess will reduce, correct? Will reduce. Yes. But some, it is added excess. So some amount of Cr2O7 will be remain behind. Yes.
Yes.
Will remain behind. So what has to be done? You have to titrate that K2Cr2O7 with help of some X normal FAS. What is FAS?
Ferrous ammonium sulfate.
Yes, ferrous ammonium sulfate. You have to titrate that K2Cr2O7 with ferrous ammonium sulfate. Whatever reading you will be getting is called as back reading, because some amount of K2Cr2O7 is consumed and remaining back K2Cr2O7 you are titrating with X normal of FAS. Okay, that is your back reading. Then you have to take a distilled water. And you have to add the same excess of K2Cr2O7 to it. You have to reflux it for 1.5 hours. You have to reflux it for 1.5 hours. And then you have to titrate it with titrate it with X normal FAS. Will the K2Cr2O7 content will reduce? Distilled water, sewage water, I have put distilled water and done the same thing. Will the K2Cr2O7 content will reduce?
No, ma'am.
No, it will not reduce. It just control. It is just control, so it will not reduce. And you are titrating it with the X normal FAS. X normal FAS, correct? Okay. So that reading where oxygen, oxidizing agent will not reduce to the extent where the in sewage sample it is reduced, that reading is called as blank reading. That reading is called as blank reading. In that, instead of sewage sample, sample is used, distilled water sample is used. Okay, have you understood blank reading? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, abhi hum log yahan dekhte hain ZMLO. Ye dekho. ZMLO sewage sample plus excess amount of K2Cr2O7 plus dilute H2SO4 plus Ag2SO4 catalyst reflux for 1.5 hours. Back reading, titrate with X normal FAS. B, distilled water plus excess of K2O7 plus dilute H2SO4 plus Ag2SO4 reflux for 1.5 hour. Blank reading, titrate with X normal of FAS. So after titration, whatever reading comes is a blank reading. After titration, here whatever reading is the back reading. Okay. And what is ferrous ammonium sulfate? FeSO4, NH4 twice, SO4, H2O6, H2O. Okay. Now see the stoichiometry. Thousand ml of one normal FAS is equal to 8 grams of O. What is 8 grams of O? Equivalent weight of O. Okay, this is the stoichiometry. 1000 ml of one normal, anything one normal consumes equivalent weight of that other part. Okay, so 8 grams of O. Okay, 8 grams of O. You know, no, equivalent weight of O is 8. Like you must be knowing the definition of equivalent weight, like 1 part by weight of hydrogen, 8 parts by weight of oxygen, and 35.5 parts by weight of chlorine. किया है ना?
Yes, ma'am.
हाँ, तो 8 grams of oxygen यहाँ पे. Then blank minus back means whatever K2Cr2O7 consumed, that reading of FAS into x normal of FAS is equal to COD correct? This you got it? Hello, this you got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So blank minus back into FAS into 8 into 1000. Why have multiplied 8 with 1000? Because this is grams. And we know the units of the BOD and COD is mg per liter. Okay. So I have multiplied this with 1000 to convert into mg. Grams to mg upon 1000. क्योंकि ये 1000 नीचे आ गया, ये ऊपर गया, ये ऊपर गया, ये 1000 नीचे आ गया, ये x ऊपर गया, ये एक 1 नीचे आ गया, फिर ये COD यहाँ आ गया एंड 8 ग्राम्स यहाँ आ गया. करेक्ट? गॉट इट? ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन. यस, गॉट इट? हेलो.
यस
मैम.
ओके, सो we can write it down as blank, ye 1000 cancelled out, so we can write it down as blank minus back into x of x normal FAS into 8 is equal to COD. But this is just in mg, we want mg per liter, so what we have done, ZML of blank minus back into x normal FAS into 8. So 1000 ml के लिए कितना है? ZML के लिए इतना है, तो 1000 ml के लिए कितना है? 1000 ऊपर गया, Z नीचे आ गया, ये हो गया. तो COD का formula ये हो गया. Got it? So you just write down the last formula. At the end, whatever the formula is there, you just write down. Yes, have you written down?
Yes, ma'am.
चलो हम लोग प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करते हैं इसके ऊपर. Just try one. 25 ml of sewage water sample was refused with. 25 ml of sewage water sample was refused with. 25 ml of sewage water sample was refused with. 10 ml of 0.25 normal K2Cr2O7. 10 ml of 0.2 normal K2Cr2O7 solution in presence of dilute H2SO4, Ag2SO4, and HgSO4, The unreacted dichromate required, unreacted dichromate required 5.5 ml of 0.1 normal ferrous ammonium sulfate, 0.1 normal of ferrous ammonium sulfate, 10 ml of same K2Cr2O solution, 10 ml of same K2Cr2O7 solution, and 25 ml of distilled water, and 25 ml of distilled water under same conditions as the sample required 15 ml of 0.1 normal 15 ml of 15 ml of 0.1 normal ferrous ammonium sulfate. Calculate the COD of sewage water sample. I'll repeat again. A 25 ml of sewage water sample was refluxed with 10 ml of 0.29 normal K2Cr2O7 solution in presence of dilute H2SO4, Ag2SO4, and HgSO4. The unreacted dichromate required 5.5 ml of 0.1 normal ferrous ammonium sulfate. Unreacted dichromate required 5.5 ml of 0.1 normal ferrous ammonium sulfate. 10 ml of same sample required. 10 ml of same sample required. 15 ml of 0.1 normal ferrous ammonium sulfate. Calculate the COD of sewage water sample. Come on, do it. Yeah.
Normal. Can you please solve this question on paper?
Yeah. See, I will tell you a very simple thing. Just forget about the K2Cr2O7 in this question. Okay, in the problem, just forget about K2Cr2O7. Just concentrate on FAS. And then just substitute the FAS values in the formula. Okay, so here it is given that, I'll just show you. This is the formula, isn't it? This is the formula. What is the formula? COD is equal to blank minus back into X naught to 8000 upon Z. Z is what? Hello? Z is what? Volume of sewage sample. Okay? Yes, ma'am. Okay, this is the volume of sewage sample. Blank, you know. I told you the blank. Back also, you know. It is the
FAS. Can you repeat blank and back?
Blank and back, maine diya na yahan pe. Z ml of sewage sample plus excess amount of K2Cr2O7 plus dilute H2SO4 plus Ag2SO4 catalyst, reflux it for 1.5 hours. And then titrate it with the X normal FAS. Whatever the titration reading is there, that is a back reading. Distilled water, instead of sewage sample, X ml of sewage sample, a distilled water is taken. excess of K2Cr2O7 is taken, dilute H2SO4 is taken, and reflux it for 1.5 hour kiya. बाद में क्या किया उसको टाइट्रेट एक्स नॉर्मल एफएस से किया ओके एक्स नॉर्मल एफएस से किया दैट रीडिंग इज कॉल्ड एज ब्लैंक रीडिंग दैट रीडिंग इज कॉल्ड एज ब्लैंक रीडिंग सो ब्लैंक मस बैक इनटू एक्स नॉर्मल ऑफ एफएस इनटू 8000 अपॉन एक्स ये कैसे आ गया मैंने बता दिया ना यहाँ पे आपको हेलो
यस
हाँ तो ब्लैंक रीडिंग कितना है Tank reading कितना है यहाँ पे देखो 25 ml of sewage water sample was refluxed with 10 ml of 0.25 normal K2Cr2O7 solution in the presence of dilute H2SO4, Ag2SO4, HgSO4. Unreacted diatomate यानी जो remaining back बचा है required 5.5 ml of 0.1 normal ferrous ammonium sulfate. Correct? Unreacted dichromate required. Ye sentence very important hai. Ferrous ammonium sulfate. Kitna chahiye usko? 5.5 ml chahiye. Aur kitna normal chahiye? 0.1 normal. 0.1 normal. तो 5.5 क्या हो गया बैक रीडिंग इज इक्वल टू 5.5 ml ओके व्हाट इज ब्लैंक रीडिंग
15 ml
ब्लैंक रीडिंग क्या है यहाँ पे 10 ml ऑफ सेम सैंपल इज रिक्वायर्ड 15 ml of 0.1 normal FAS solution. FAS 15 ml of 0.1 normal. So 15 ml. Correct? Or normality of FAS kitna ho gaya? X normal FAS is equal to 0.1. Or Z ml kitna? Z is equal to kitna hai?
25 ml
of waste sample is taken. Chalo, solve karo abhi. Chalo, solve karo. What is the answer? Okay, have you understood the problems?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, aur ek le lo. 5 ml of sample of wastewater was refluxed with 5 ml of sample wastewater was refluxed with 30 ml of potassium dichromate solution 30 ml of potassium dichromate solution after refluxing the excess unreacted chromate required X unreacted dichromate required 23 ml of 0.1 molar FAS 0.1 molar FAS a blank of distilled on refluxing a blank of distilled water on refluxing with 30 ml of dichromate solution required with 30 ml of dichromate solution required molar same hi hota hai Yeah, blank distilled water, blank of distilled water on refluxing with 30 ml of dichromate solution required, 36 ml of 0.1 normal FAS solution. Calculate COD value of the wastewater. Calculate COD value of wastewater. Yeah, a 5 ml of wastewater was refluxed with 30 ml of potassium dichromate solution, and after refluxing, the excess unreacted dichromate required 23 ml of 0.1 molar FAS solution. A blank of distilled water on refluxing with 30 of dichromate solution required 36 ml of 0.1 molar FAS solution. Calculate the COD value of this water sample.
And is it 2080 ppm?
Yeah, 2080. Correct. 2080. Got it? Everybody got it? Yeah?
Ma'am, by writing the answer, should we use ppm or mg per liter?
Yes, anything. Mg per liter or ppm. Anything is done. Right. But that unit, unit is must. Okay? अभी थोड़ा डिफरेंट टाइप का सम डालते हैं. अभी नॉर्मलिटी डिफरेंट होगा. ओके, नॉर्मलिटी इज डिफरेंट. व्हाट यू विल डू, यू जस्ट चेक. 25 ml of effluent was analyzed for COD. 25 ml of effluent was analyzed for COD. The back titration reading with unreacted K2Cr2O7. Back titration reading with unreacted K2Cr2O7 was 10 ml of 0.2 normal FAS, 0.02 normal of FAS. Unreacted K2Cr2O7 was 10 ml of 0.02 normal of FAS. If blank titration reading was 25 ml of 0.01 normal FAS, blank titration reading was 25 ml of 0.01 normal FAS, calculate COD of effluent. Calculate COD of effluent. Yeah.
In this case, would we do N1 V1 minus N2 V2?
Yeah. Either you do N1 V1 or milliequivalence ko equate karna.
Ma'am, can you repeat the question again?
Question again. Okay. 25 ml of effluent analyzed for COD. The back titration reading with unreacted K2Cr2O7 was 10 ml of 0.02 normal FAS. If blank titration reading was 25 ml of 0.01 normal FAS, calculate the COD of effluent.
Ma'am, back titration reading with unreacted?
Back titration reading was 25 ml of 0.01 normal FAS. Back titration reading with unreacted K2Cr2O7 was 10 ml of 0.02 normal FAS.
Ma'am, is it 16 ppm?
Yes, 16 ppm. How many of you got the answer of 16 ppm? Only one. सबको मिल गया 16 ppm. गुड. किसको नहीं मिला, किसको डाउट है? भाविका, यू गॉट इट?
यस मैम.
ओके, 16 ppm. सबको मिल गया 16 ppm.
Yes, ma'am.
So I have not solved it, isn't it? किसी को डाउट है तो अभी बोलना. Don't get shy. नहीं आया तो नहीं आया. पूछो.
मैम normal of FAS calculation mistake.
Normal of FAS calculation mistake. क्या कैलकुलेशन मिस्टेक है
मैम? आई थिंक मेरा गलत निकल रहा है.
क्यों, क्या आंसर आ गया आपका
मैम? 0.002
FAS है और 0.01 FAS है. बैक रीडिंग में 0.02 FAS है और ब्लैंक रीडिंग में 0.01 FAS है. You have to use N1V1 formula, or otherwise you have to do one very easy thing you have to do. किसी को नहीं आया तो ये समझ लो. COD is equal to milli equivalence of blank minus milli equivalence of back. Okay. So into 8000. अभी नॉर्मालिटी इधर हम लोग दे दिया, नॉर्मालिटी को हम लोग इसको मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया दोनों, तो हम लोग 8000 डायरेक्टली लिखेंगे. डिवाइड बाय वॉल्यूम ऑफ सैंपल 0.01 इज द नॉर्मालिटी ऑफ ब्लैंक, इज इट? यस ऑर नो? यस ऑर नो? या 0.01 is normality of blank into 25 is the volume of blank into 25 is volume of blank minus 0.02 is normality of back, 0.02 is normality of back into volume of back, okay, into volume of back into 8000 upon 25. So kitna aa gaya answer? Yes. Yes. समझ में आ गया क्या? Got it? Everybody? Is it an easier way to do it? Huh? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
It's an easier.
Yes, ma'am.
बाद में वो N1V1 करके एक नॉर्मलिटी फिक्स करके वो वापस वॉल्यूम निकालने का थोड़ा टीडियस होता है. इससे अच्छा यही मेथड है.
दिस N1V1 ओनली ना?
हां, दिस इज आल्सो N1V1 ओनली, बट सम पीपल व्हाट दे डू यू नो, दे फिक्स द नॉर्मलिटी एंड देन दे जस्ट फाइंड आउट द वॉल्यूम, करेक्ट? And then there, that will be a thoda tedious hota hai. Ye to directly N1V1 dal
de. Ma'am, these sums when they come in the exam,
yes.
In the steps, kaun sa step important hai?
Arey steps, jabhi wo final exam ko aayega, tabhi ye sab steps important hai. Aisa hi hona chahiye. Jaisa likha hai na, waisa hi hona chahiye.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. लेकिन अभी तो ये एग्जाम के लिए अभी तो एमसीक्यू ही पूछेंगे. योर टेस्ट टेस्ट जो रहता है ना, टेस्ट वन एंड टेस्ट टू के लिए एमसीक्यू पूछेंगे. लेकिन जब भी फाइनल एग्जाम रहता है तभी ये पूरा सॉल्व होना चाहिए. यू विल बी सॉल्विंग इट इन ऑन द पेपर ओके एंड देन अपलोडिंग इट. गॉट इट? और एक चाहिए प्रॉब्लम नहीं?
यस
चलो ले लो. ML of Swiss sample was used for COD analysis. 25 ml of Swiss sample was used for COD analysis. The back titration reading with unreacted potassium dichromate. Back titration reading with unreacted potassium dichromate. Was 7 ml of 0.2 normal FAS. Was 7 ml of 0.2 normal FAS. If blank titration reading with 25 ml of distilled water. If blank titration reading with 25 ml of distilled water. Is 30 ml of 0.1 normal FAS. Is 30 ml of 0.1 normal FAS. Calculate COD of effluent. Calculate COD of effluent.
Is it 5 1?
512, correct. Answer is correct. 1 minute, huh? I take the presenting.
Ma'am, 512.
Roll number 1.
Present.
2.
Present, ma'am.
3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5. 6.
Present, ma'am.
7.
Present, ma'am.
8.
Present, ma'am.
9.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12. 13.
12.
Okay. 13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15. 16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18. 19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26.
Present, ma'am.
27. 28. 29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31. 32.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Present, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40.
Present.
41.
Present, ma'am.
42.
Present ma'am.
43. 54.
Present ma'am. Present ma'am.
45. 46.
Present ma'am.
47.
Present ma'am.
48.
Present ma'am.
49.
Present ma'am.
50.
Present ma'am.
51.
Present ma'am.
52.
Present ma'am.
53.
Present ma'am.
54.
Present ma'am.
55.
Present ma'am.
56.
Present ma'am.
57.
Present ma'am.
58.
Present ma'am.
59.
Present ma'am.
60.
Present ma'am.
61.
Present ma'am.
62. 63.
Present ma'am.
64.
Present ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, that's the answer 512.
512, correct.
Thanks, ma'am.
Answer is 512. Okay, I have put the PPT of BOD COD in this Google Classroom. Just check it.